Photographs, 64 pages, and it's only $4. that flight that ran from the summit of Pikes Peak all the way down to Colorado City and Colorado Springs. Well, he came out here to check on his invention to see how it was working, and he took a burrow ride to the summit of Pikes Peak. A 3-day long burrow ride to the summit of Pikes Peak. The horizon line is a little over 200 miles away within the great state of Kansas. They're over on the west slope of Pikes Peak doing their rut right now. Now on the two-seat side of the train, you can see the stone building. This is the old section crew house. Now we saw our section crew back in 4 Mile, but back before they had their own trains, they actually lived in this house, and then they would pick up their tools and walk to wherever they had to work on the track every day. 20 section crew members and the section boss and his family would live in that house during the summertime. In fact, there was a baby born in that house, and that baby grew up to work on the Con Railway for over 50 years. Now we are going to stop here for a minute. We got some downbound trains coming. Now's probably a great time to stand up, stretch your legs a little bit. But listen for Jimmy. He's going to tell you when to sit back down.
I'll tell you why.
We all know that no matter how careful we are when we're eating popcorn, some of it always ends up on the floor. And when it ends up on the floor, it's going to get ground down. It's going to end up in our engine compartments beneath the train. And when we park the train in the sheds at night, the mice can smell that popcorn from miles around and they come running. And the mice are not very smart. They can't tell the difference between popcorn and sophisticated Swiss wiring. And if they eat at the wiring, I'm the guy that has to crawl in there and fix it. So please, no corn on the cob.
I mean, there are a million dads in the alliance.
coffee bars.
So you was in Colorado
when you came over to this room? Yes. Is it being so
young. got no one.